Hello, hello, everybody. How are you all doing today? It is me, your bestest bear bud day, and welcome to our little chill art stream today. How is everybody doing? I hope y'all are doing well. I'm not gonna lie. Okay, I've heard... So, where do I start with this mini tangent that I'm about to go on? Okay, so I have heard that there are some people that when they wake up, they are, like, confused as to where they are, and they have to, like, gain grounding and, like, bring themselves back to reality after sleeping. I have never experienced such a thing. I honestly kind of thought, you know, that kind of sounds like something's wrong there. Maybe we want to get that checked out, like, being so ignorant about it. But earlier, I was taking a nap. It was only an hour and a half nap, pretty much, and I was woke up. I was so confused at what I had to do because I woke up and I knew I had to stream, but I guess I was confused in that I felt like I hadn't streamed in such a long time and I was nervous to get back into it, but I was like, but I just streamed yesterday. I couldn't understand the concept of me getting up and going to go stream. Like, I don't know. I was so confused like that. I don't know what was going through my head. I was going through like a little mini psychosis, I guess. I don't know. I just woke up confused. It's like, I know what I have to do, but how the fuck do I do that? And it's like, you've been doing it for the past, not even 6 months now, like almost like 7 months. Oh my god, it's 7 months today, I think. Like, you've been doing this a year, you know how to stream. Like, what's going on? It kind of scared me a little bit. And even when I like walked into the room and I was getting ready, it still wasn't clicking yet. Like, I think I was just half asleep. I guess that's what it was. I guess I was technically like still asleep. And that's why I was getting a little fucked up by like that, but oh my god, I was so out of it. I'm glad I kind of snapped out of it as I turned on the computer. I was like, oh wait a minute, I know what I'm doing now. I was like, okay, I finally know where I am, I know what I'm supposed to do, I know how to do it, blah blah blah. Oh my gosh, that like first like, I don't know, 10 minutes though of like trying to figure it out was just rough. But I'm okay now. I figured it out. I guess it was just, I don't know. I finally was like, you know what? I understand now. I think I understand people that wake up confused now, but because it kind of freaked me out that it just like happened like so easily. I don't know what caused it. I don't know if it was like from exhaustion. Like, I was tired, but I wasn't exhausted. So I don't know. I don't know what it was. I'm losing my mind. Dae loses their mind. All right. Caught on stream. Hell yeah. Let's go. But other than that, I've had a pretty good day today. I've been, you know, I'm going to go ahead and start the background music already before I forget. I've had a pretty alright day. We're working on some stuff in the living room, so that's been a little bit of a stress factor. But, you know, it is what it is when it comes to, like, trying to, like, fix shit up, you know? Alright, let me pin this. So, background music we've used plenty of times before. So some of you might be familiar with it. So there's that. It makes me so annoyed that it doesn't go away in OBS. I just keep saying, unpin this message, unpin after, hide for your... Oh, never mind. I fixed the problem, never mind. Here I was complaining. But yeah, for those of you that don't know that are here, last week... So as you guys see here, I have a little buddy here. That's BB, for those of you that don't know. This is evil BB, but this is BB, and he is a bear bud, just like you guys are bear bud. But last week we started making concepts for other bear buds, and it was a lot of fun. Y'all gave me some nice tips and ideas and stuff like that. And today we're just kind of like bouncing off of that and like continuing. So we're like refining some stuff. I'm trying to draw like the other bear buds like in action, so I can like get more used to love. Their proportions and stuff like that, and just as I go, because you know I can only do so much by just drawing them like just standing still in like a pose, not a T pose, but like an A pose. So that's basically what I'm doing today. It's just a doodle day pretty much, but also concept work at the same time. I just want to draw bears. Tornado Coon joined the chat today. Oh, hello Tornado Coon, welcome back. Oh, Tornado Coon, I missed you from the last time I almost potentially saw you. What was it, like, last week, maybe? It's good to see you again, old friend. Even though you're mildly psychotic. fresh outside, kind of breezy. That's when Anakin's coming. They're like, okay, I went up into the mountains to go visit the bear. Now I'm coming back down. Back to Hugo. Back into Hugo's loving arms. Aren't you so lucky to have such a nice friend in Tornadocoon, Hugo? They just love you so much. They just want to be near you always. That's always going to be such a meme, though. Like, every time I see a Hugo, I'm just like, oh my god, where's Tornadocoon at? A little inside joke. The river's loving the Tornadocoon, I guess. I guess so. You know what? Good for them. They seem to have a very happy relationship. But yeah, let me go ahead and switch on over. Let me show you guys what we did last time for those of you that weren't here. Ah, there we go. So yeah, these are the other bear buds we have made. So mostly we were trying to like put together the proportions because I figured to make it a bit easier is to have like two, like three. Well, actually, technically it's two because BB is the only middle-sized bear. And then we have the bigger bear, which we will call the group like Grizzes, and the smaller ones, which are called Teddies. And then I also tried to mess around with some like color variations. I don't know if I wanted to be this dramatic, like the two on the right here, between the little teddies here. But it is a thought, because it would be nice to like break it up, the sea of the dark brown, just a little bit. But the goal is not to like make BB like... The goal is to make BB stand out. So I don't want to make any of them stand out too much that you BB blends into the background, which I think I'm doing okay so far. He is differently proportioned. Like the others, paws tend to be a bit more proportioned to their bodies, while BB's is still like oversized pretty much. And I might try to make that, adjust that just a little bit so they're more proportioned, because they do tend to get a little bit bigger here. I might mess around with the legs as well. But we also played around with the concept that since we live in the woods, you know, people hike through the woods all the time, and they, you know, they leave stuff behind, of course. So I was thinking, you know, I think the bear buds would like to take that stuff for themselves and play around with it. So the one up here has a backpack that he stole. I'm gonna find this backpack definitely, because you can't even tell it's a backpack. But I made it purple because I thought Dora explored. And then I have this little chef bear, who is basically, and this one is kind of like using like a t-shirt that he's wrapped around himself and like styled into be like a sort of apron. I'm not sure I'm gonna stick with that. We will be drawing him a little bit, doing some different types of aprons to see what looks good, what looks nice. Of course, and then there's BB here. And then we have the two little buds here. We have one with some cracked glasses. They can't see shit through those glasses, but they think they're funky, so they still wear them. And then we have the one on the top here has been dubbed specifically BB's sister, Tabby, or Tab for short. Now, all the bear buds, they're all related, of course. They're all a family. But you can't really figure out who specifically... There's no reason to... They're all kind of like siblings in a way. So when I say, like, Tabby is BB's... is BB's sister, that doesn't really mean, like, strictly. But, like, they're close and... closer to each other than the rest of them are to each other. So they're kind of like, you know, siblings, you know? More so than the rest. They're just close, you know? Because they look alike anyway, too. Tiny Tabby. Yes, just a tiny baby. And then Jack had a really good idea for a set of twins, a little twin teddies, who each wear a shoe from one set. And they're like the little twin tears. I thought it was good. Now, don't think I'm gonna make the Grizzes like just one size and the Teddies one size. Like there'll definitely be like some variations. Like I feel like Tab would be like the smallest of the Teddies, but they'll still be like, you can still tell which one is a Teddy and which one is a Grizz. You know, they're not gonna be that dramatic of a difference. So yeah, that's pretty much what we got done. So we'll be playing around with that. So basically, just trying to like draw like the characters like in motion, in character. Like I said earlier, get a feel for like the proportions and stuff, and like make adjustments as I go along. Because this is, like, everything here isn't set. Also, BB has eyebrows. I don't know if anybody noticed that either, but I gave BB eyebrows because, I don't know, maybe BB 2.0 in the future? Maybe? Maybe. Maybe BB have eyebrows? Because I like that he has eyebrows. I think it makes him look more expressive and such. So I was thinking about, I don't know yet, but then I kind of think, when I look over at the grizzes over here, I feel like, oh my god, they definitely need eyebrows though. Got a whole lot of nothing going on. But yeah, so that's what I'll be doing. So I've already started doodling. Uh-oh. I'm sorry, I was doodling without you guys, and I went over here and I started doodling a little Tabby and BB. Oh, shit, I've been flipped this whole entire time. Damn, I did not even know that. I don't know how I do that. Like, sometimes I'll just, like, start drawing, and I'll end up, like, figuring out that the whole time I've been drawing, I have the canvas flipped, and then I flip it around. It's like, oh, wow, now I see everything. I want to squeeze both. Me too. It's so pretty. What? Why you got the devil in there? What is that? What? Hugo, you're getting a little aggressive here, man. Don't squeeze him too hard, I swear. You're just little bears, Hugo. It's okay. I'm gonna squeeze them both. That's the impression I was getting. See, I was drawing a little bit of them in motion. Because I think they are cute. They love each other. We're all family here. When you're here, you're family. Whose slogan is that? Is it a fast food chain that has that slogan? Or is that... Why would a fast food chain have that slogan? You're here, you're family? What the hell? I don't know. Who has that slogan now, actually? When you're here, your family. What? Whose is that? Olive Garden. Okay, so it's not fast food. No sudden movement. Give me all your BBs. No. They're my BBs. You can't have them. You go put the gun away. Please. They're my BBs. They're my family. Gimme. No! No! Oh, no, you can't. Not Jack's gun. Wait a minute. Where? Joke's on you. I also have a gun. So now what? What's your next plan here?
That's what I thought. Bitch.
Nah, I'm just kidding. That was a little too aggressive. That was too aggressive, I say, after pulling a gun on you. I mean, I got a little aggressive with that. Sorry. Okay, make him bigger. There we go.
Yeah, Tabby.
Only jokes, man. I'm sorry. I apologize. I'm sorry, I apologize.
Okay, I want to continue with this little sketch here.
Oh god. Acting like I can't fucking draw when I have BB right here in my arms to use as reference. Oh, I don't know what you look like. BB, I can't see you. Where are you? Him sitting here. So that's what we've been pretty much doing, like bare bud concepts, and also in turn like a little world building as well for this little world we have here in the forest. It's been very fun. It's been very nice, and I like hearing all the ideas you guys have as well, and like the roles that the bare buds have, because like I mentioned before, we had like a cooking one, we have one that has like a backpack who is kind of like the collector, I guess you could say, like the junk collector that gets like all these items and brings them back to share with the rest of the buds. BB is kind of like the leader here.
Oh, thank you, Jack, for the save check. Oh my gosh, I have to make a new file, right? Okay, where's my mascot for? There we go. Doodle bears, that's what I'll call it. There we go. Okay, show off that nose just a little bit. There we go, that's more. That's a baby mouth right there. It's pretty much taking BB and going, but what if he had friends? Besides Twig, you know? Friends from his own home, you know? Oh god, I can't even see what the... Zoom in! Enhance! Zoom, enhance! Clear up the image. There he is. It's Bigfoot. No. I don't know why, but lately Bigfoot's just been on the mind. Ever since we went on that hike with Baxter yesterday in our life. Oh my gosh, I am so... I don't know how I'm going to make it till next week to play it in the next session of Our Life. I am so excited to keep learning more of Baxter's story and such like that. I mentioned last time, last stream at the end, but I'm really curious on how we're going to get reconnected with him in the first place. Because when we got reconnected with Cove, that was pretty, what would you call it? Like, expected, because Cove has been our friend for like the last like almost 20 years. I think you can like live with him, stuff like that. Derek is our friend that we've promised to, I didn't even copy it, whoops, promised to keep in touch after he moved away. But Baxter ghosted us. We don't know where he went. He went back to like Virginia and then just poof, and he said, I'm not coming back. Just like, I want to know, how did this rat come back? Oh shit, I fucking had that and now I don't. But it will have to wait till another time. But I am very excited. Also, it's a little bit sweet too, because after we are done with Baxter's route, I'm planning on not continuing the Our Life streams, at least for the long while, because we've pretty much done all the routes for the main three boys, which is only the three boys, so you know what I mean. We've done a route for each of them, and I thought that was pretty good. That gives you guys a taste for what Our Life is all about, pretty much, and I hope that encourages you guys to go get the game and play it. So if you guys want to know what the different other routes look like and how to play the routes differently, then I encourage you to play it on your own time, you know? I wonder if it looks like he's looking at her. There we go. And he's looking down at her, that he's like, oh my god, my baby sister. Oh, that may be a little bit too much. That's a little too much slant there. I'm sorry, BB. Let me fix you. It is kind of hard to make them look like they're looking down. Probably should. The guard's going pretty alright. We've just started with like our first little doodle, and we're doodling up some BB and Tabby. Some BB and Tabby love and appreciation here. So it's going all right. And then we'll be like drawing some more. I definitely want to draw more of the grizzes, especially because I feel like I don't have the proportions down for them as much as I want them to be. So we'll be doing that after we finish this little sketch. This is like our warm-up sketch, pretty much. And the warm-up sketch is turning out to be fucking hard. Like, what the fuck? I don't know why I always...
BB, why are you always such a struggle to draw? Damn.
It's hard to capture so much orb beauty. The dodgeball beauty. You know, I feel like it's the eyes. No more eyes for you. The warm-up sketch will end up being the stream. Listen, shh, don't say that, because it will be happen. It will. Listen, Jack. Yeah, y'all have gotten a taste for how long it takes me to draw anything. Don't speak it into existence. Don't manifest it. I'm trying. I'm trying to be better. I'm not the bear I once was. 5 minutes ago. I'm different. I'm changed. Puppet! It's all Puppet's fault. What? I see that. Puppet, thank you so much for the raid. Thank you. How was your stream? What were y'all up to? Welcome, everybody. Here, let me hurry up and give a shout out to Puppet. Puppet. Ooh-woo. There we go. Make sure it's working there.
Yeah, you're good. Just make it to that little island on the... Over in there, yonder.
You just gotta make it.
Yeah, I over there. You just gotta swim over there.
Whoa!
No!
Whoa!
Nice. Geez, Xenoblade 1. Hell yeah. First it was Deep Rock, which was nice. Then it was Risk of Rain, which crashed. Oh, well, that's not so nice. Well, I hope you had a good time regardless. Yeah, welcome in, everybody. My name is Dae Ursa. I am a bear PNG tuber. I tend to stream Monday through Friday throughout the week. I play video games majority of the time, which tend to be between like visual novels, and I played Pokemon recently. What game would you consider Subnautica being? Because that's also what I'm playing right now too. Subnautica game genre and adventure games, I guess that could be said. But yeah, I also do some art once in a while as well, and today we're drawing some little bear friends from a little bear mascot here. You're welcome. Survival game, technically. Okay, thank you. Yeah, survival games too as well. Say welcome in, everybody. It was a very unplanned stream. You know what? Those are usually the best. Someone throw a win at me? What'd they throw? What? I don't understand. But yeah, those are pretty much the games I like to play. But yeah, if you got a raid and dash, if you guys need to go get something to eat, get some sleep, get some water, you got stuff to do, feel free to do so. I thank you guys for hanging out with me for this little bit and stopping by. And I hope you guys have a good rest of your day. And for those of you that are sticking around, I hope you enjoy the rest of your time here. Who threw wine at you? What the hell? What happened? What's going on, Will? Will's been having a hard time lately. But yeah, so yeah, we were just drawing some characters here. This one right here is going to be BB, my little mascot. And hello, next to him is we call him his little sister, Tabby. I'm not sure if they're directly siblings, but they act like siblings. So it is his sister. Just pretty much doing some lore here. A little bit of lore hints, a little treat of lore just for you guys. Okay, so now getting that in. Oh, I guess I'll show it after the ad break, but I could show the rest of the bear buds that we have did little sketches for as well. Okay, this needs to small one down just a little bit. There we go. little belly. Yeah, 10 seconds left for the ad break. Ad break ended. Your community is back. Hell yeah. Welcome back, guys. Alright, so I was eating at that drunk family member in front of me. I throw wine when I cover my right ear and said not to raise my arm. Oh, that's shitty of them. I fucking hate drunk family members. Wine thrown at them, damn. I've tricked Felix into letting me clip his hit nails. Hell yeah. We love trickery. Trickery. I'm letting the nails get clipped. Good for Felix. Good for Felix. We're getting easily manipulated. But yeah, so those of you that are just now joining in, these are the beer buds we have done so far for like a brief initial concepts for. Which we will be exploring further down, mostly like just trying to figure out proportions and stuff, but we're trying to draw them actually in character and not as these ominous A-pose models here. Just to help figure that out a bit more, but yeah. So I had to go home without my favorite sweet, thanks to my sensory issues today. The restaurant was very busy. Yeah, restaurants can get a little hectic sometimes. Oh my gosh, I was in a Costco the other day, and oh my gosh, I was getting a little overwhelmed by all the noises going around too, and all the people and stuff. People are ruthless in Costco. Oh my god. I was just trying to like follow my friends along, and like people would like cut in front of you and then stop, and then you'd have to stop behind them, and you just get left behind. Well, not left behind, but it can be aggravating. Let's see, can I do a correct eye this time? No, I'll be brave. I'll try to draw it. Scroll that in. There we go. Happy, happy, happy. Dun, 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 dun. Happy, happy, happy. Oh, his earrings, damn. You can't forget his earrings. That's what connects us together. Worst part is that my mother was forced to bring me home. I'm sorry about that, but at least you're home now and away from all that chaos. Relax just a little bit, you know? Alright, let's get this arm. I don't know how correct the internet. Yeah, I was kind of looking at the like side eyeing it, like, what the hell? How did that happen? A I used to have known this dude, like, way back when, who didn't have, like, the best grammar and spelling. And, like, you know, being, like, a shitty cub at the time, I kind of, like, made fun of him sometimes. And be like, why can't you just type it correctly? It's this is how you spell it. And be like, I do type it correctly, but it autocorrects. And it's like, then why isn't it not correct? You know? Me being an asshole and giving him shit. Now these days, I don't even have proper grammar or type correctly. Okay, now we have... Hi, Shaggy. How are you today? I didn't get to talk much to you yesterday. Because I heard you had a pretty hectic, week. How was Beyonce? Did you see her? Shaggy, did you see Beyonce last week? They all have fangies. Yeah, I heard you were being very busy, so how are you doing today? I hope you got some rest, some proper rest. It has pictures and a video I shall post. Ooh, okay. Very exciting. Do that. There we go. It's like, I was gonna erase his belly, but I don't want to. I'm good. Well rested. Hell yeah. We love to see it. We love a well rested bud. Hell yeah. Just hungies. Yeah. I can understand that. I had me some good mushroom pasta earlier. It was pretty. It was pretty nice. I liked it. Yeah, munch, munch then. We'll go eat something then, Shaggy. Feed yourself. I'll redeem it just for you. Oh yeah, like the treat box. Food not done. Wait, that's munch for me, not Shaggy. That means I have to eat. Alright, fine, then I will eat. What food are you making, Shaggy? Oh, here we go. I have some caramel corn popcorn sort of thing. Everyone munch. Okay. That means you have to as well. I'm gonna eat this. I'm slowly running out of snacks. In here. I'll have to get some more here soon and see. How does this taste? It's caramel corn. Okay, I got some rice too. Hell yeah. Thank you, Will. Rice. I'll put it right here. There we go. Oh, where's my chopsticks? Oh, what if I take the chopsticks and just... Shh, they're not gonna know. Who's gonna know? They're not gonna know. Hell yeah.
No.
Shh, shut the fuck up, baby. You don't know shit. Keep it a secret. Nana making fish. Ooh, fish. Some brain food.
Can I have a bite?
Yes, you can always have a bite. I'll share with you. I don't want you going on a silent strike just because I didn't share again. Although you haven't gone on a silent strike in a long time. I must be doing pretty good at sharing. Here, I'll feed it to you. Even though, since you don't have thumbs, you can't use chopsticks, really. You can just hold it so here. I'll just be like, eh. Hey. Here you go. Nom nom nom. There you go. Delicious. Give me that bice. This caramel corn's actually pretty good. I was going to eat it off stream one time for like a snack. But sugar is bad for bears, but this rice does not have sugar.
A trash.
The caramel corn's for me. I'm sure in the race with BB. There's not much anyway.
I want the popcorn.
Well, you can't have the popcorn. It's mine. Don't be greedy. I'm letting you have the rice. The rice is, in my opinion, is much better, so.
Be happy with what you have.
Keep like trying to like make progress, but then I'm like, I need more popcorn. And she got her arm up in the air, like, yay, BB. That's how everybody reacts when they say BB. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Get back in there. We ain't done yet. Get back in there. Alright. All done. All done. I was trying to say all gone and all done at the same time. I can't speak. Bok! Welcome. How are you today? I hope you're doing well. Welcome, welcome. Yeah. Oh, I don't know why, but seeing Bok reminded me. I forgot to congratulate the people that got first and second. Congratulations, Hugo, for getting first and Shaggy for getting second. I forgot that. Just popping in. Yeah, I understand. Thank you for popping in. I appreciate that. It's always good to see you, Bok. Don't be a stranger. Yeah. Let's get this little baby Yorm in there. There we go. She said, yay! I'm not sure what Tabby's role would be within the Force. I think she's just like a helper. I think she just likes to help out everybody where she can. She's so little, so she probably helps out with stuff that like it requires getting into like the nooks and crannies of the cabin or in the forest. She's a receptionist. She is. You know what? That's right. She's a receptionist. She's HR. Somebody has a work complaint. They go up to her. This child. And she's just there like...
There seems to be the problem. We need to create a nice work environment here.
Except she don't talk, but if she did talk, that's how she would talk. One thing I do struggle with is drawing their legs, because their legs are so stubby, but I don't know how to make it look good when they are messing around, you know? Like when they're dancing.
The writing is very good.
Is it? Are you learning to write alongside Tabby? Is Tabby helping you write as well? Does she go along with you to go take classes from Twig?
Yes, she does sometimes.
Yeah. That's good. I'm glad you all hang out together. I wondered if you take her with you whenever you go traveling. I know you would never take her anywhere dangerous that you weren't confident you could protect her from. Not everybody, not all bear buds are as feral as BB can be. There we go. Yeah, yeah. Tebby once expressed interest in getting her ears pierced just like BB, but he said no. And I agreed. She's too little. We ain't like one of those parents that takes their babies up to Claire's and gets their ear pierced at like, what, 6 months old? I every time I see a baby with pierced ears, I just look at them and like, why? Why do your parents hate you? Like, what even is the reason for it? Like, what is so important that they have to like pierce a baby's ears for?
The aesthetic? My baby doesn't match my aesthetic, so we're gonna get her ears pierced.
Honey, the baby was just born, like, my sister did that to her kids. Oh my god. Why? I also had mine done. Ugh. Did they give a reason as to why, or is it just, I don't know, messing around, you know? I never asked, to be honest. You know what? Maybe you should. Just sitting there casually at a family dinner and you go, so, mom, dad, why'd you make me get like my ears pierced as a kid? Why would you make a choice like that for your kid? Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, you're literally putting a hole in your child's ear for jewelry. Like, what is the reason? What is the reason? Also, hi, Kira. Welcome. How was Fortnite? Are you still playing Fortnite? No, you are not. So how was Fortnite? So for me, I had to stop wearing earrings because all the cheap shit is metal, make fake nails, which I'm allergic to. Oh, nice. That's fun and quirky. A blast. Hell yeah. You look like you were having some fun. So I'm glad. Prop hunt with everyone. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I saw you guys playing that yesterday when I was lurking in Kit's stream. I'm not sure if anybody else was streaming it yesterday, but I saw it from Kit. And then I had to pierce them again when I got older because they scarred up. Yeah. It's just... Rech. Only Kit was streaming, I believe. Ah, okay. Damn, Kit was hosted a whole fucking party on the stream. There were so many people playing, too. But nah, it's good for Kit. Like I said, it all looked very much fun. God, I remember I would watch a lot of YouTubers play a prop hunt on Gmod when I was younger, and I thought the game looked so much fun to play. My friend and I finally got Gmod like years later, but we tried to play a prop hunt like just the two of us, and we could not get it to work. It was so sad. Party at Kit's place, hell yeah. Kit throws the best parties. World known party thrower. There we go. Oh, this always looks so weird to me. I need to like put some sort of shoulder indication in here. Yeah, something like that. Oh, what's that one game that's kind of like Prop Night? That's what I'm thinking of. I did play that game. That's like a prop hunt, like horror game. It was pretty fun. I liked playing it. Unfortunately, my friend couldn't really run it very well. And I don't like to play horror games by myself, but it was pretty nice. Except for Dead by Daylight. I can play Dead by Daylight by myself pretty good. Man, I haven't played in so long. Then I heard that they put in Nicolas Cage, and now I'm kind of like, do I reinstall? than by daylight, just for Nicolas Cage? The answer is, of course, yes, but... I thought that was just such an odd move. Oh, that game. I never played Prop Night. It was fun. It was nice. It's kind of hard to, like, get used to at first. Especially, like, when you're, like, as the prop. But once you get the hang of it, it can be pretty nice. You can have some nice clutch moments. I think I played it back when it... When did it come out? I don't want to say I played it back when it first came out. Then not have played it. Let me see. Where's Prop Night? Let me look it up. Prop. No, not V. Spacebar. Night. Why does it not show up? Where is... There it is. Oh, it's because it's one word. Sorry, I put a space in there. December 1st. Okay, so I didn't play it. I guess I kind of played it around the time when it might have came out. Maybe like a month afterward. So there might have been like plenty of changes afterward. So I don't know. I like how all the reviews are mixed. I finally remember what movie I wanted to add to the movie name list. Movies Wonderland. Oh, okay. A Nick Cage movie. There you go. You're welcome. I helped. I'll take credit. No, I'm just kidding. But yeah, get it on there. I never make it to the movie, right? But I do like to vote for the movie. It's like, it's just to state my opinion, but I keep missing like the last few votes. I'm like, damn it. Like, by the time I remember, it's like Friday and like the movie has already been like watched pretty much. It's like, damn it, I can't put my vote in. I'll have to remember this time. Let me... The arm might be a little too long. I give you all the credit because you helped me remember. Thank you. As you should. I also vote off the first one, but get too confused when trying to vote on the second one. Yeah. I think I keep voting for like the same ones too. I think I keep voting for Iron Giant because I love that movie. It is very nice. And there's like one other one I vote for as well, but I can't remember what it was. Okay, that looks a little better now. Yeah, so sweet. Okay, this is fucking with me. Here, flip that. Okay, there. Now when I flip the canvas, it's this way. Because I keep... This is like the proper view that I keep wanting it to be. If you want to watch the Iron Giant, I can do an extra movie night when you can watch it along. Oh. That'd be nice. But you don't have to make a special occasion just for me. No, it's gonna happen. It's gonna happen naturally. I will make the people vote for the Iron Giant and make you all watch it. I don't mind, the list is long enough anyways. That is true. You do got a lot of movies on there. And plenty to go through. I wanna see the list. Why am I in the FNAF theorizing channel? What? Okay, movie suggestions. No, that's not it. Oh. Who's closing the door? Yeah, that's a big long list. I get confused trying to like put in like the reactive images for like my my polls and all his five options. I don't know how y'all do this. Oh my god, what is this? A fish? But what if? Yeah, I do love me a pole though. Even though y'all don't, y'all make ties on mine. It's never a clear winner. Okay, ish. Oh, it is a pain to do, but I do it every week, so I got used to it. Yeah, it just becomes like sort of like muscle memory pretty much at that point. I'm just kinda like, okay, this one, this image for this one for that one, blah blah blah. Yeah. Well, why are there, who is closing the door so aggressively in this house? Oh my goodness. Am I getting robbed? Oh my god, if I got robbed on stream, would you guys save me? Would you guys help me? I really shouldn't joke about that because what if it is a robber? It is like 5 p.m. It is still bright outside. I doubt I'm getting robbed. I doubt anybody in this neighborhood has balls to do that. I mean, I got my dog and my BB here, so... it should be okay. Okay. Oh god, Jack's right. I am just gonna spend the whole stream on this one single doodle. Jack, you took it back, but it's still not enough. Okay, you know what? Forget it. I'm coloring now. I want to color! I want to color more often. I never color, so I need to color. Now that I have the two interacting with each other, I can mess around with the colors just a little bit for Tabby to see what I like and don't like. Because it is a little different. She doesn't have as much gradient as her bear brother does. Up to the top. Did I give her? Oh, that's not you.
Yeah, Tabby, you're some nerd with your broken glasses. Get out of here.
Does she have any gradient, actually? I don't know why I did that. That didn't help. Where are you? I did not give her a name. No. Name your folders, guys. I can't. There she is, okay. What are you... there we go. Do you have a gradient? Kinda. I think she just has it on her face. I think that's what it is. So she actually doesn't have it in her ears. Oopsies! Get that out of here. So erase this. So she just has it like right here. Yeah. Yeah. Go back to you. Okay, let's open up. I need mouth wide open. I'll open this one. Ta-da! Wait, wrong one. There we go. Ah, damn it. Okay. Now, do I want eyebrows? Maybe leave them without for now, but there's still a thought in my head. I'm still thinking about them. A nice little glow here. I've lost my liner color. Oh well. Siblings. Okay. There we go. Our first sketch after an hour. We love to see it. Okay, let's put this in a folder. Okay, now I want to draw some of the bigger bears. I'll keep this up. I'll put them up here. There we go. Specifically that chef bear that we had going. The one over here. I want to draw this one. I want to develop him a little bit. I don't know. He quirky. He funky. He got a nice little apron, you know? Okay, so circle. I did say I wanted to mess with like the grizz bear's proportions a bit more. So I think I'll use it like this time to like make some concepts for like his apron as well. Because I think that's just going to be, like, his, like, tying to him to his role is just his apron. I feel like my pencil isn't big enough. Let's try that. Like, why is he so damn small? It's too damn big. Wait, I can just do this. Okay, yeah, you guys can't see, but I can see it. Zoom out, because it's just way too big of a window for me that nobody can see me adjusting. There, I'll put them here. Have y'all seen that one post with the person like, oh my god, I hear so much down scares. I guess it's Santa Claus. Well, help yourself, Santa, to whatever's in the fridge. And then they later posted, I got fucking robbed. Showing their place trashed. That's me right now. I'm like, I keep hearing these noises downstairs. I'm like, whoever it is, I hope y'all have a good time. Then go down there like, I've been robbed. Although if I was truly being robbed, Sam would let me know. She would definitely let me know. She'd let me know even if I wasn't being robbed. She'd just be like, somebody here, intruder alert. Bump, 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 bump. Oh, second. Thank you. got an Oreo blizzard. The door opened and my mom just walked in. She had it. I was like, where'd you get that? And she said, Dairy Queen. And I was like, well, yeah. But so, blizzard break. I've done barely anything, but blizzard break. What a nice little surprise. I don't know what it's been lately, but lately I've just been on such an ice cream kick. I don't know why, but like every day I'm like, man, I really could go for some ice cream right now. And delicious. What's y'all's favorite flavor ice creams? I usually get vanilla if it's just like plain ice cream. Chocolate doesn't really hit it for me. Unless it's a chocolate frosty from Wendy's, then I'll definitely get chocolate. But 9 times out of 10, I'll be getting vanilla ice cream items. I wanted sweet. My foot is asleep. I can't move it or else it'll feel weird. I say as I attempt to move it. This dude be slapping though. It's been a while since I got a blizzard. I used to go to Dairy Queen about almost every Monday. Way back when, but then we just stopped recently. I miss it. I'll try to work while I'm eating as well. You look a little funky, but that's okay. They're all a little funky. Are the DQs in your area actually sanitary? Because they ain't here. Let's just say I would be surprised if they were. I'm gonna say probably not, but you know, if I die, I die. I mean, it seems alright enough on the inside, so I'll give them some credit. They seem pretty sanitary. You know what? Fair. Yeah, yeah. I had a friend in Jersey work for one day and left because of how nasty it was. Ew, gross. Imagine you get hired at the job, you're nervous, you go in, it's just like a pig pen in there, like nasty as hell. Like, so this is what we've been working indefinitely until you found a better job. It's like, nah, I'm just gonna go. Was like, I know cleanliness can be hard, but when you work in the fast food place, I think that should be like a big priority, you know? And that's just me. Hey, what do I know? I'm lucky to have never had to work in the food business, and I don't think I ever will want to. Because people are fucking animals when it comes to food. Oh my gosh.
Listen, I want this burger charred. I want it burnt. And if it's not burnt enough, I want my money back.
Yeah, it was a while ago, so I don't entirely remember correctly, but I think one of the things was not washing things out correctly, and the floors were disgusting. Ugh. Mm-mm. I could not stand that. I can barely handle my own workplace, and my workplace is pretty alright, but you know. It can get a little grody, but still. It's like, no thanks. But it could just be at that one place. I've never gone to DQ. Yeah, there's probably some areas that are just cleaner than others. Let's try not to stereotype all Dairy Queens to be nasty. But when you've only experienced one Dairy Queen and it's nasty, I mean, it's kind of hard to break out of that until you find one that's not. Okay, so getting into the apron part, I'm going to make this one into the, what do you call it, the shirt, pretty much. So basically, it's like a long sleeve shirt. Where the sleeves are tied in the back, pretty much. And then they cut the fringe down on the bottom just to give it some flavor, you know? That'll be like the first. The first apron. Maybe I should draw in a better position where you could actually see it. Like, I wanted to do some poses, but I was like, maybe this wasn't the best pose. Like, wearing a hoodie around your waist, but the other way. Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna, oh my god, you know what? I don't even have to have this image right here on my screen. I could put it up on my other monitor. Hell yeah. And I can see all of them. There we go. Also, that reminds me, I want to show you one of the lore images I made, because I popped off. Ooh, yeah, show me. Send it my way. DM it to me. Oh, wait, that's the wrong image I'm playing with here. There we go. I have my, it covered my face, but you know, when you see me. What the fuck? This one. So,
you send it? Are you sending it to me? Jack, where is it? Send me the image!
This kid gets increasingly more and more fucked up. Wait, give me a sec. No, no. Go fast! And I'm just kidding. Yeah, take your time. Wait a damn minute. Yeah, I think this shows it off a bit better. I was not prepared to send it immediately. Ooh, you should always be prepared. I always want to see. Okay. I want to see my friend's art. Let me see. I want to see my friend's art. Give it to me. So yeah, it's pretty much like tying a hoodie around the waist, but just the other way, with a bear. I kind of imagine that maybe the bear, Bud, saw a chef or like somebody cooking with an apron and thought, oh my god, I need something just like that. But maybe we did not have access to an actual apron. So maybe they just kind of like, the backpack bear came by and had like this long shirt. And just like, and then they just got the idea to tie it around themselves. Or maybe they saw like maybe me when I take my jacket off and I tie it around my waist. And they kind of went, oh, I have an idea. Maybe it was something like that. At least that was the idea for the initial thing. It has been sent. Let me see. Ooh, oh my god. I like that. Very nice. You did pop off. You were not kidding. 11 out of 10. No, 12 out of 10. 12 million out of 10. Very nice, Jack. Very excited to see it all completed. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, now let me clean up the sketch just a little bit. Yeah, I don't want to say too much because I don't want to spoil, but you know, it's, and y'all missing out. Man, it sucks to be you guys. You can't see it, but I can. I'm working hard, but also speedrunning a little bit because I want to have it done before school starts. Yeah, since you have more time now, when do you go back to school? If you don't mind me asking. I know it's soon. Just gotta wait for Halloween. Yeah. It's gonna be a very nice. Oh my god, I can't believe Jack leaving us to go back to school. I start again on the 28th, but I'm not going to be leaving anywhere since it's online school. Oh, that's good, yeah. Hell yeah. Get to stay home with Felix and Pico. And Bear. Nice. Honestly, when I had to switch to online schooling in 2020 because of the big Rona, I heard like a lot of people are really struggling with online schooling, and which I can understand that. Like some people are more like need to be in the classroom to learn, but I was thriving. Maybe not in like the actual classes, but getting the assignments done, I really enjoyed it. Like I was comfortable, get my work done, just throw it into the thing, not have to present it or anything. It was nice. Normal college system is way too much for my brain. Yeah, I understand that. I get that. It's nice to just be home in your own element where you thrive and survive. Have no shame name dropping them now. I hated attending Drexel. I have never heard that name before, so you know what? You go off. You go off. Go off, Jack. Put them on blast like you did J figures. Cause some colleges, they just ain't it, you know? Especially the art courses, because that's only 10-week quarters, and they stack you up on classes. So, is it like they're trying to like shove a lot in like a short amount of time? And that's not very nice to go through. My first few terms in the game design was 20, so that's 21 credits.
That's a lot. It's been a while since I attended college, but that is a lot. sounding to me.
I think when I attended, I only had like take like 15 credits per semester, pretty much. 21 is the max, by the way.
Yeah, so a lot.
I wish. Listen, I when it comes, I didn't go to like an actual art school. I went to like a university that happened to have an animation program. So I think I did pretty all right in like missing out on the overworking max classes that some art schools do. I'm not sure if you attended like a specific art school either. I kind of got that when I switched to math as my major, but it didn't help much to let me just stay. Yeah.
It's just a lot.
Drexel isn't even an art school. And they're doing this for what? For what? Doing all that, and they even aren't school. Who do they think they are? I almost did attend an actual art school, but I ended up not because of cost. I was kind of bummed about it, but then later on I heard that they had some issues with people getting very mentally ill taking their classes. I was like, you know what? Maybe I dodged a bullet, actually. A family member of mine actually ended up going there later. I don't think she had any of those issues, but she did get hit by a car down there. So, I mean, you know what? Maybe it's good I didn't go. She's okay, by the way. It happened, like, I don't know, like a couple of years ago. She was not okay at the time, but she's okay now. I think she was biking and some old lady just like smacked right into her. That wasn't even looking. The math major, I would have 15 credits, but then classes would also require labs and recitations, which didn't count as a credit, so it just filled up the schedule and was a lot. Yeah, I can understand that. Yeah, I'm grateful my schedule was pretty lax compared to yours. I almost did take a minor in philosophy, which would have kind of like made it a bit more stacked because I was considering taking it up late, and so I'd have to probably like do like a lot of makeup classes, but I ended up not doing it anyway because I don't know. I guess I cowered out. I was turning left off the street I was crossing. I was halfway through the crosswalk and just stared at them when they stopped. I almost got hit in the Philly while coming back from getting groceries. Just looking at them, just going, do it. Hit me. Do it right now. Pay off my student debt. The money you'll get from them. But I remember I don't think I even like heard about it from a family member. I think I just happened to be on Facebook and like she had posted, got hit by a car. It's like, what? Her mom had to come down and like, I guess, get her. I don't know if they like brought her back here because it was a school out of state. So I don't know if they like brought her back or what happened. Oh my gosh, Novora, thank you so much for the raid. Thank you. So casually. Kinda. I mean, not so much casually. But yes, welcome. We're just casually talking about how my family member got hit by a car one time. But welcome. Let me give you a shout out. Is it going to be the pilk clip?
Can I get an egg?
Oh, no, it's not the pilk clip.
Okay, I'll get an egg.
I'm dead.
Can I get an egg?
What the heck? Come on, Nova. No!
No pilk this time. Yay. New clip. But yeah, welcome in everybody. For those of you that do not know me, my name is Dae Ursa. I am a bear PNG tuber. I stream Monday through Friday typically throughout the week. I play a variety of video games. I've been playing some Nautica. I've been getting always in Pokemon recently. And every Tuesday we do an art stream. And today we are drawing some bear butts. I thought I had bought the bridge egg, but I just bought a regular snowball. Oh, I see now. I understand now that, like, the staring into the abyss. Just watching it go fall down. It's like, I see. We're playing Pokemon tomorrow. Yes, Jack and I are playing Pokemon tomorrow. It's drawing so adorable, by the way. Thank you, thank you. So basically what we're doing is we're drawing some other bear buds to go along with my bud BB down here. And right now we're drawing a bear bud that takes on, because each bear bud kind of takes on a role here in the forest. And this guy is the chef. So we're trying to draw him. I'm trying to like figure out the proportions and stuff as well. So that's why he's kind of in a little pose here. We're trying to figure out what kind of apron we are going to draw as well.
It is me, MBB.
You are BB. MBB. I gotta fix my meds, but have a great stream. Okay. I hope that fixing the meds goes well. Thank you so much. And for any of you guys that need a raid and dash to go eat, sleep, get some water, just rest, you know what? Feel free to do so. I thank y'all for stopping by. And for those of you that stick around, I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your time here. It's pretty much like a chill doodle stream. I say it's a concept stream to make it sound more important than it is, but that's pretty much just what's going on. I like making them do a little dance. Okay, yeah, that is what we have been doing. I have a tamed lap cat. Ooh, which cat? The one that will hurt you if you don't pet it. Pico, yeah. Okay, now I can draw. Eyeballs, yay. I'll say, I'm gonna draw this a little bit more funky, like, yeah. Pico. Oh, that reminds me. Her solution to me not petting her, hopping up now, which is much preferred, yeah. You get to pet the kitty. Well, I remember I was playing Animal Crossing the last time I streamed it, and we got Pico on our island, and she's just been waiting to move in because I haven't let her move in yet because I'm waiting to stream it again to like get the other two villagers before I put the houses down. That Pico will get to come home someday. I'm so excited. Actually, Colton moved off my island. I'll have to see who's moving into spot. Ooh, nice. I'm gonna make, when I stream next, to make it like a villager hunting stream. So I'm trying to like grind up some Nook Miles tickets to fly. I wanna make like a little like chart of like villagers I'm looking for too. As well, like the dreamy chart. I used to follow this girl that would play Animal Crossing and do streams and like videos like that. And I ate that shit up. I was like, I loved watching those. I loved watching those streams. So it's like, finally, I could be the one to do it now and get disappointed at who I see. And another thing, I got some Animal Crossing amiibo cards. I got the Sanrio collection. So when we get to campsite, afterward, I could invite
a certain someone over. Mayhaps. I don't know if that's how that works, though. I don't know. I don't know if the Sanrio ones are different than, like, getting them on your island. Hey, yeah. I don't have them up here. I brought them home, and I was like, I better put them in my office before I forget. And guess what? I forgot. It's the same process. Okay, good. I didn't know if they were quirky or whatever. So this is pretty much the first one. Okay, here's the sleeve. Let's tie it in the back. I'll give him like the spatula too, because he just kind of like puts the spatula, tucks it in. A little spatula. Pigo has moved to the desk now. She's moving up in the world. Good for Pigo. Spatula. Yeah, okay, so, oh my god, why are you so big? Dae, does the cabin follow health code standards? It's clean, if that's what you mean. It's not rash, I keep it clean. And by me, I mean the buds keep it clean. Listen, the most you'll probably find is like muddy footprints, but that's about it. And don't worry, this guy here, he takes cooking very seriously. Listen, he's not one to, like, take the spatula and, like, press it against himself while he's tucking it in his pocket and then take it back out with, like, hair all over it. Don't worry, that's not what I'm getting at here. What do we call the chef? Chef, maybe? What should we call the chef? Chef Grizz? But no, then it'll get confusing, because when we say, oh, it was the Grizz, but like the Chef Grizz or the other Grizzes? It might seem confusing trying to like figure out which one's which, but I think that's what makes it like charming as well. I think that's what makes it funny. What about Chef Bread? Oh my god, that'd be so cute. And he can bake bread as well. That'd be so nice. Yeah, yeah. There we go. We'll call it Chef Bread. And then up here is the other bitches, Tabby and BB. I wouldn't say all the bear buds are named, but those are the ones that like kind of, you know, put in an effort to, you know, pull their weight and stuff like that, and make they make a name for themselves, you know? It just kind of like happens on their own. Some of them are probably content with not having a name, but others are probably like, I want a name. BB was stuck with his name. He didn't get to choose. I looked at him and was like, oh my god, BB. This your name is BB. And he was like, what? I bestowed a name upon you. Okay, so now we're doing this next one. So this next idea I had for Chef Bread is a little, I don't know, it's a bit more like a DIY, probably, than the other one, I would say. Basically, I was thinking, maybe I should wait until I'm like actually drawing the ape brain before I start Yeah, I'll wait. So let me. But yeah, I think Chef Brad would very much enjoy cooking. He takes it very seriously. Probably one of the bears that take it their job roles the most seriously. Because food is fuel, you know? Oh, not another rare one. Okay, chef. Oh, I wanted to draw like a little height chart too between me and the other buds as well. I'll have to see if I can have time for that at some point in stream. I'm losing the proportions a little bit. There we go. I kind of like that the bigger bears, the muzzle kind of looks a bit more like a mustache. Is Brad a grizz? Yes, Brad is a grizz. And I'd imagine he might be one of the more bigger of the grizzes as well. Maybe a little thicker. You know what? That's a good thought. Make him more thick. Now, but just because he's bigger, I don't want to. Man, I wonder why. I don't know. It's a mystery. No, I don't. Also, I don't want to. If people to like equal that, grizzes equal older and teddies equal younger, because that's not always the case either. I think sometimes people just grow different, you know. Some people just grow different. Okay, look at his little legs. But they're not so little because he's so big. Some people are just short, yeah. Now Tabby is young. Tabby is she's short and she's young. I would say. One of the younger ones at least. Now Chef Bread, I don't know about Chef Bread. BB is definitely one of the older ones, definitely. Is he the oldest? No, because I am. But I don't know about Chef Bread. Okay, how do I make his tummy pop more? I want him to be a fat, huggable bear. Yeah, there we go, yeah. Kind of strut that tummy out. We love a tummy. He got the bear dad bod, yeah. Just gotta make sure all the buds get fed. Okay, and then, so for this next idea for an apron, I thought that maybe they'd be a bit more simpler in that he just had a rope and then there was like a piece of cloth, like maybe like a towel or something that he would wear under. So it was kind of be like, go around like this. And then it would wrap around. Yeah, yeah. Lower it just a little bit. Maybe sometimes he trips over the apron. He trips over while he's trying to bring food to the table. And it gets ruined. No, that's so sad. I can't think about that. Food being uneaten. There we go. Yeah, something like this. And then there's like some like splotches already on it. Nah, Chef Bread is too much of a pro. Yeah, but maybe in the beginning. Chef Bread would have to come to me and be like, cut this, it's too long. Maybe that's why he's chunkier, because he eats.
Yeah, because when he falls down, he face plants into the food. He's like, well, I mean, I'm already here.
And like some texture. Oh, maybe not too much texture. I don't want to make it seem like he's dirty, because he's not dirty. He keeps up cleanliness.
But he's not one of the ones... He's not a dishwasher, though. Like, he makes sure he keeps his area clean, but the other buds have to clean up the mess afterward, because he cooked the food. It's only fair that we, the other buds, not me, they clean up after, you know? Clean up the supper.
Okay, maybe we'll give, like, a little bit of texture on this sketch, just to show it's kind of like a towel of sorts.
Then...
go ahead and erase this part. And then I have one more idea after this one. I think I got the proportions a bit better on this one. This one just kind of looks like a fucked up BB, but this one actually kind of looks like somebody different.
Yeah, maybe you would go up to him and be like, oh my gosh, BB. And then you walk up and get closer and like, oh my god, BB, you got fat. BB impersonating bread, yeah. BB, you got fat. Fatter than usual.
Chef Bread just starts crying.
I do kind of have the impression, we love the chunky boy, we do. I get kind of the impression already that Chef Bread is a sweetheart. He is a gentle giant amongst the bears. He's very sensitive. He's, you know, they say you put a lot of your heart into cooking, a lot of love. And I think that's what Chef Bread tries to make a stand for, you know? He loves his little family. He loves to feed people, make sure they're fed, and he wants that to taste through his cooking and through his personality. He's one of the bears to go to for advice while giving them tasty treats. Yeah, yeah. Like, let's say, like, maybe Tabby's having, like, gets a little upset about something, and she goes over to Chef Bread with tears in her eyes, and he just looks at her, goes... turns back to what he was working on and reveals he was baking cookies and gives her a cookie to make her feel better, you know? Oh, that's such a cute image. I want to draw that now.
It's also kind of the one where, like, you find yourself, you're trying to, like, be upset by yourself and he comes by with snacks.
So you gotta make sure you eat. He's as sweet as the treats he makes.
Images in today's head very subtly.
Yes, it was. It is very subtly.
It's, yeah, you're twiddling your fingers evilly like there was like a villain's who's like, yes, it's all going according to plan.
You know, I think also would be maybe like a nice blink and you miss a detail is to maybe have like some like a little bit of scarring on his pads, because maybe from all the times he's had to handle hot food and he did not use oven mitts, just like forgotten to or something. Then it's happened enough time that it kind of leaves a little bit of scarring there, or just like some, you know, detail there in general. You know, I don't even think I'm gonna go over this sketch again. I think this was pretty nice as it is. Yeah, just a little bit to make him show that you know, this is what he does, you know? There we go. Yeah, I like this one. I think Chef Bread really was coming into the character here, and I have one last idea for the apron. I bet y'all can't guess what it is. Oh my god. It totally can't be an actual regular apron that got tailored to him. But the type of apron, you shall see. It's Chef Bread. It's kind of funny how you just draw one image of a character, and so slowly over time they start actually like growing into themselves, you know. Time for Roblox. Hop up with Roblox, Shaggy. This canvas needs to be bigger. One sec. Change canvas size. Oh, thank you, Shaggy, for the safe check. Let me end with a sippy sippy. I actually have some water left. Make it large. 6,000 by 6,000. There we go. Don't mind the flashbang. Yes. Alright, now we can move everybody over. Alright, save. Make that the size of a model canvas, yeah. Alright, so let's move these two, the siblings, up here. I'm gonna move Chef Bread here. We're gonna move other Chef Bread here. And then here. Yes. And then we'll put them all side by side. Ooh, Thunder has entered my area. Ooh. Thunder has entered the chat. Oops. Hot single thunders in your area. Oh, ooh. Oh my god, in my area? I gotta get on that. Like all those other whack ass ads too. It's like, this dude's penis grew 3 feet long by taking this pill. Just all those fucked up ads. Okay, there we go, mustache. I say mustache, but it's his muzzle. I'm trying to make it look like he's looking down, like. I gotta be careful because I'm starting to try to go into like the cleanup sketch when I'm not even done with like the rough sketch yet, so let me. Do that. Then we can put them all together. I should probably color them, actually. Then we'll put them all together and figure out which one we like the best. This to look like he's holding it up. That's too long. That's like BB arm length. No one has as long as arms as BB does.
how else can he choke out his enemies? Can make it. Oh.
They are perfect for fighting.
Yeah. Perfect for swinging. Excuse me. A large in charge. Except he's not. In charge of dinner. At Chef Brid. Look at. Yeah. Yeah, I say, unconfident. I didn't want to say this because I didn't want to put the idea out there and then I not to do it for a long time, but I was considering making a little comics about these bear buds and then like posting them on like Tipastic or Webtoon or somewhere. Because I think it'd be nice, just little short comics, like a little slice of life, like episodic. There's no really true big story going on there. And just be focusing on the buds and their little antics that they get into. I thought it'd be kind of fun and quirky. And I want to get into comics too. That was pretty much like what the idea I had after I got out of college, is like I wanted to make my own comics, but then life got in the way. So I thought maybe this would be a good step, you know? It's part of my streaming gig. So I'd have, like, a reason to do it. I could actually, like, do, like, the comics here on stream as well. Go work with me stream. I'm not sure when I would get around to it. It's probably, like, way down the line. But I was thinking about it. I was just thinking about it. Yes, he does look quite bulbous here. I love it. Whoops. That is not a belly spot at all. Okay, now we get into the actual apron. He'll have arms eventually, don't worry. So let me see. Let me look up the apron I'm thinking of. Apron. Let me add this one keyword here. Maybe that'll help me out. Yes. This is the idea I had. I hate that there's so many risque images here, but I guess that's what I get for typing in that. Okay. I'm gonna get comfy. Bum, bum, bum. What? Excuse me? Okay, so pretty much this last idea I had for the regular apron kind of looks like it's from like a maid outfit, pretty much. And that's what I was going for. So it's pretty much like a circle, and then you have like this like frill on the end of it. Ah, yes, yes, yes. That's why. So I typed in maid apron, and then I got a bunch of like images. not terribly risque, but like some of them was kind of like chill out. So that's the other idea I had, because I thought it looked cute. I thought it'd be look nice with him, you know. Just the meeting. What did you just say? The pain of looking for reference. Yeah. Y'all thought I was looking at dirty images. I was not. I was trying to look up wholesome pictures for my cube chef bread here. Yeah, yeah. Because I typed in like regular apron. Just give me a like, regular chef apron. And while maybe that is more fitting for him, that's not what I wanted. I want it cute. I want it cuddly. I thought some of these kind of aprons had pockets in them, but the ones I'm seeing don't. I mean, I guess I could just give him a... Wait. There it is. I found it. I'm just confused what you would have typed to get that result. I typed in maid apron. That was it. And that is what it gave me. Okay, yeah. And then he has pockets, so he can put stuff in there. Okay, this is a bit big. So let me, like, take this. Smaller. And why aren't you in uniform? To figure out this arm. Chef Bread, your arms. He's like, what about them? Chef Bread. And his specialty is making bread. But he makes everything. God, someday I can imagine just having like a wiki of all of the Bear Bud characters in this world. Okay, let's erase the belly. Oh god, I can't even tell what I'm supposed to be erasing, what I'm not supposed to be. There, we'll do it like that. Yeah, there we go. we go. OMG, the Dae Wiki, yeah! Tear. Oh. Gives me the dad apron vibe, that is like bright fucking pink, yeah. Rude Automod, I know! Listen, you're not allowed to emphasize with curse words, apparently. I'm not allowed to say fuck. Well, apparently you are that time. I don't know how to spell helmed. Oh, someone's mad. It's the dog. She's angry at somebody. Ah, wrong one. Ah! I thought maybe one of the bear buds could be somewhat of a tailor, but honestly, they don't have thumbs, so I don't know how that's really gonna work out for them. I don't think they can do the hemming. Oh, come on, I can do a better speech bubble than that. Oh god, come on! Okay, that's better. Yay! Okay, there we go. And here we have the three chef breads. All together. Wait. Okay. He went through the stages of chef. Yeah! Oh my god, you know what? That is true. Started with a shirt because he wanted to pretend to be a chef. Then he got a little bit more into it. Then he thought having a towel would be a bit more better in keeping up cleanliness. And then we got him an actual apron. Wait. Bread. Let's get this bread. I'll number them. Oh my god, we're getting chef bread lore. Chef bread lore before my own lore? It's not fair. He's just a cub in the first one. Yeah, he's a little baby. Chef bread, my lore. Okay, let's color them before we make our final decision, if we make a decision. I think we just ended up deciding doing all three, but in different stages, so. But you know, still, it's fine. For the funsies. Okay. I color anyway because I want to. Honestly, Twig don't have any lore aside from just being my buddy. Yeah. I mean, BB has some lore. Not a lot. It's none that's different from the, I don't know, it was not much we know that happened before the incident. Wink wink. What is the incident? You'll never know. Let's get this thing done. The incident. I shouldn't really describe it as an incident because it wasn't really an incident. And even what I'm thinking of, I don't think it'll happen in this video. This lore. It might be like a for a future video. I'm not sure. I haven't decided yet. I'm still planning some stuff. Jack, you're out here almost done with your stuff, and I'm still haven't even started mine, barely. I'm too busy drawing chef bread! It's on par with the bite of 87 and 83. I mean, yeah. I am speed. You are speed. I mean, you have a reason to be speed, too. Jack speed. Jack go fast. Again down here. Take a little. So happy. I set my date only a few months away. Panic. I mean, you still got time. We'll be alright. You got it, Jack. I believe in you. Okay, I need. My thing, and I need to go over here. Give me that color. I believe too, but the perfectionist in me is kicking in. Yeah. I haven't given myself a date yet. There is. I did have an idea of a time, but that is very soon, and I don't think I will get it done in time. Definitely not. But basically, when something, some hypothetical gets finalized, then I'll have to start rushing, because then I'm like, oh god, now I have to actually get this going, so. That's when I'll start kicking in the high gear, really. But for now, I'm just taking my time. I'm just trying to... I'm being a perfectionist and just still planning for months and months until I finally get around to doing it. It's how I... That's my perfectionism. Planning and never getting anything done. And when I have a physical finish, you don't gotta rush. Well, I mean, that's true, but also it's like, but I wanna use it ASAP, you know? Like, I want you, but I wanna do other stuff too to go along with it. That is of my own thing. Okay, what should I color those stains? I was about to do yellow, but I was like, that seems like it's piss, so I don't know if I want to do a piss color. I'll do brown. Do like a kill. Yeah. Yeah, that's not bad. Yeah, something like that. And then down here, what does Chef Bread keep in the pockets of this apron? Seasoning? I mean, I did say he was cleanliness, but sometimes he might be a little out there. Hot pink was mentioned though, so I do want to do another version like that. Hot pink. 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 Bam, 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 bam. Yes, he does the cooking. No, he doesn't do the cleaning. Maybe more on the red side. Yeah, more on the red side is better. Give a nice Barbie energy. Okay, there we go. All right, so here is our Chef Bread's aprons. Now, I know we did say it could just be like a timeline of his apron development, but what do we think? Which one do we think fits the vibe? I like the thought of number one, but honestly, two and three kind of hit more, in my opinion. I was gonna do different colors too, damn it. Of like his actual fur. Let me see. Now he is Chef Bread, so I was kind of thinking maybe to make his fur a bit lighter. To be a more of a bread color. Yeah, something like this, maybe. And then this one, maybe let me a little darker. Maybe he gets a little bit of older energy. Maybe even more grade. And show his wisdom, maybe. Mayhaps. Yeah, there we go. Alright. So, yeah. Because I do kind of want to mess around with colors just a little bit. I don't want to make, like, two different... A drastic amount of colors. Because they are of the same species, pretty much. But, yeah, this is what we got for Chef Bread. I mean, I do like the frilly. I do like number three. Number three is pretty good. But I do like the colors of number two as well. I'll leave it up here for just a moment while I think about it. But he is Chef Bread though, so I feel like lighter colors would be more apt to it. Maybe if I just make it the base default color more saturated. I wonder how that would look. Let's see. Phew. Ooh. Oh, I think I put the shirt in the wrong layer. Oops. Oh well. Oh, the shirt's blending in with it. That's what's going on. I see now. Basically, I just kind of want him to be more warm toned. As a chef is, you know? So let's see, maybe a bit more saturated. It's like, now it's more bread. Let me see if I can get it more on the orange side than the red. Yeah, like, but I want it gold and not yellow. Okay, that's just pretty much, just might as well leave it at zero there. Okay, I think I'll take this. This is way too red. Actually, let me bring this up. Give me this. Put it more this way. No, that's not. There we go. Yeah, this is what I'm thinking of. Yeah. Give me that color. Bread colored, yeah. That's why he's Chef Bread. We'll make this lighter and a bit more saturated. There we go, okay.
But I don't know. Is it too different, though? I mean, not really. See, I want it to be different, but still similar. And I think I might just be thinking too hard about it. Honestly, maybe though, we could just leave it that the muzzle and the markings are more bread-collared. That's also a thing that we could try out. Like the accent, maybe? And give me this. Give me that. And then what if I... Ooh, it's too big. And shoo. This is much to think about, much indeed. The bread man has lots to think about, not just recipes. We love to see it though, but yeah, I'll let that fester. And they went to draw another picture. Of Mr. Bread. Wanted to offer making soup. That's it. Soup. Nice little potato soup. And the ladle. Or maybe I should make the ladle like this way. I'm glad we're doing this today too, because like I need to get better drawing, like moving these arms around, drawing like the body in motion. No, I should have drawn bread. Listen, he has many talents. He is a talented bear. Store event. Epic Games, get out of here. There. Get out. Oh my gosh. I hate that they give me desk notifications because I don't care. Well, that is way too round. It would look more like he was smiling, but that doesn't really help. You just have to feel the emotion. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna be streaming for too much longer since I'm kind of like
still feeling the effects of yesterday's stream, so I think I might just finish up this image and then we'll call it there. Honestly, I wouldn't mind just making this like our the next like art streams for the next few weeks, just like taking like a bear bud and then just like developing them. Cause this was a nice little segment to like dedicate to like one of them, like Chef Bread. I really liked that. Maybe next week we can do like another one, like the backpack bear, or maybe we can move on to like go over to maybe doing a Teddy, like the twins. Give them some names, figure out their roles a bit more and their personality. I think that would be nice. Just have like each stream be dedicated to a bear bud. I mean, BB's had plenty of streams dedicated to him. He's got even got his own birthday. Yeah. There we go. I have no ideas for the twins other than the fact that I want them to have a very similar name so that it's even more confusing. Yeah, like Timmy and Tommy from like Animal Crossing. I kind of view them as being a bit more mischievous of the bear buds. We get a little bit of cheekiness. Okay, now Chef Bread is way too small in comparison to the soup here, so let me fix that. I'm thinking I'm saying his full name, not just not just Bread, just Chef Bread. I'm trying to think here. Cancel that. Wait a minute. Damn, using the government. Yeah, I'm using a government name. I'm sorry. But I think it makes him feel important to be called that, though. He's like, oh, I am the chef. Yeah, there we go. Now, I'm trying to think. Okay. I'm trying to think. You know what? I should have done the size chart, but I didn't. Okay, let me look at me and BB here. Where the fuck did this dog fur fuzz come from? I just like grabbed out of thin air and damn. Okay, so here's me and BB. If I were to be making soup and I had the pot in front of me, Chef Bread looks like he's smaller than BB, but Chef Bread's supposed to be bigger. So let me. Okay, so now if I had it. Okay, so pop in front of me. Yeah, I think that's a good sizing. Question, if you were to think of what a pumpkin would live in, what would your first thought be? I think I would think of like... I'm trying to explain my idea because I did have an immediate thought. So I kind of think... sort of underground, if that makes sense, like a little system, because since, you know, pumpkins grow from the ground, I feel it would be weird to put them in normal ass houses. Yeah, a gourd, is that how you spell it? Yeah, that's how you spell gourd. Yeah, because that's like what was my first immediate thought. I'm trying to think. Is there somebody? I don't know. I thought of Winnie the Pooh for some reason in houses there. Let's see. Winnie the Pooh. Is it Rabbit's house? Or does Rabbit live in the tree? Rabbit's house. Oh, he does kind of live in the tree, but that's also kind of what I was thinking too. It's like maybe like at the base of a tree by the garden or something. I think all the Pooh characters live in trees, yeah. Pumpkins are a type of gourd, though, so would that not be weird? The green pumpkin-looking thing. That's not weird because it's not a pumpkin. But they're from the same species, almost, though. But I think maybe it kind of, like... basically, houses maybe that are, like, built... in the ground, I guess. Not... I wouldn't say necessarily, like, a tunnel system, but kind of, like... I don't know, you know, let me... I don't know, here's the ground. So I'm thinking like a pumpkin patch, and then I have like a little dirt house, but not doesn't have to specifically be dirt. And you have like that the door here. Thank you for the sippy, Noah. Thank you, thank you. Get like a bit of a witch's hut kind of thing. Yeah, something like that. You have like the door here. Then it's kind of like wood. Kind of vibe, I mean, yeah. Like houses. Also kind of have the Ara Nara house vibes. What is that? Ara Nara house? I have never heard such a thing in my life. Oh, isn't it from Genshin? Oh, okay, yeah. Yeah, that could be something cool to do too. Yeah. The little guy's from Genshin. Yeah, I haven't gone that far yet, but yeah, something like that. They like the like round houses. They make like really good silhouettes too. But instead of like the like a circular shape, you can make it a bit more pumpkin shaped, but not from like actual pumpkins. I shall simmer on those thoughts. Yeah, I mean, if you need help building houses, I'm sure the bear buds would love to come by and help. Chef Bread will bring some food, bring some lunch for everybody while they're working so hard to build. I don't know, I feel like I want them bigger. I just want them comically bigger. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I hope that helped in some way. If you need an engineer, you know who to call. Comically large shepherd. Yeah, you can call Kira and the buds. I mean, how do you think we got this cabin here built? That's still not technically built yet because I am never decide on a concept. Okay, so then dun, 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 dun. He is standing on a step stool. And then, let's see. I'm not using reference, don't mind me. Okay, this is the fire. And here's the other burner. There we go. And here's the bowl. Yeah, I think having all these items here will help me figure out sizing. Listen, he may be short, but he's still thick, you know. Getting supper ready. And of course needs the apron as well. A different pen. I think this is for inking, though, and I don't want to. I'm not in an inking mood. I just want to use a different sketch to clean up a bit more. There we go. Maybe this one. Ooh, that's not very good. Oh. Let me save. Oh no, she's freezing. There we go. I've acquired food. Hell yeah, Shaggy. Did you bring enough for the rest of us here? Fish for everybody. I mean, I'm a bear. I'm supposed to eat fish. That's supposed to be my main diet, even though I don't like fish. Howdy, Shaggy. Fish taco. Howdy, Kira. What brings you to this part down here? It's coming along down the dusty old trail. Yeehaw. Check Discord, Dae. Did you put my fish taco in there? Yay! Ooh, it looks good. Delicious. Delicioso. You know, I don't really eat fish tacos that often. Or fish in general. I feel like I should, though. I feel like I get smarter. They do say it's brain food.
Maybe that's why I never use a brain cell. I don't eat fish. I'm supposed to. I'm a bear. It's part of my diet. It's allegedly.
Well, well, what a coincidence. You, Shaggy's brought food, and we're drawn some food. I mean, I guess this doesn't have to be on the stove. This could be taken off of the stove. Because I was just sitting here thinking about, damn, I don't want to draw a stove. I don't want to draw a stove. That's too hard. I'm supposed to be taking it easy today. Oops, I disappeared the other bear buds. Oh well. Shit, I'm trying to look here. Now I'll figure out the eye shine later. The nice mustache going. You know, he doesn't have to have such big eye shines. He could just have, like... I say that and then I made the big eye shines anyway. Oh, they just look so ominous when I draw them like that. Okay, let me... fade this out. Shit.
Do that.
That took his eyes away.
What should you like?
Oh, maybe. Well, that makes him cross-eyed, but... Oh, the struggle. Trying to figure out this bear bud style. Ooh, that's a font. Every time Chef Bread cooks, he gets these stars in his eyes. What does he look at that makes his eyes shine so brightly? Soup. Soup. He's so happy. Happy, happy, happy. Bum, 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 bum. Happy, happy, happy. There we go. I feel like with if each time that I draw him, he just gets larger and larger. He's growing. Hi, Ash. Welcome. Ash Exopeak. Hope you're doing well. Just drawing a bear bud here. Our little chef guy. Making some soup. How y'all feel about soup? I love soup. Potato soup, to be specific. I like gnocchi soup, but I don't really get that too often. I have to go to, like, Olive Garden for that. We used to make it, but we kind of, like, stopped recently. It was very good, though. It depends on the soup, yeah. I say I like soup, but I think there's a lot of soups I wouldn't eat, to be honest. I don't eat tomato soup. I don't like tomatoes that much. I like cheddar broccoli soup. I think I like the soups that, like, everybody kind of likes. The basic bitches of soups. Little burns there from years of soup making. Not bread making, soup making. I wonder if it'd be kind of like, oh, is he, you named him Chef Bread? Is it because he makes a lot of bread? No. Does he make bread? Not really. I mean, that would be funnier. I mean, not everything has to be funny, but I like funny. But he's so round and thick. I love him.
love him, protect him. The bread chef, who's not making bread, but soup. I don't know how to draw.
So focused on getting all of this correct. Okay, and then his pockets that is filled with love. That's where he carries his love, in his pockets. He takes out a cookie. Yeah, little tail. There we go.
He made some soap.
I should make it more this way because of the angle. There we go. Let me track the face a little bit more over here. There we go. I don't know if I'll color this image. As much as I struggle with colors, I'm not sure. I might just do post a sketch, but I don't know, I'll play around a little bit. I really need to get better at coloring. Coloring is just so hard for me. Like, when I know what colors I want, I kind of pop up, but when I don't know, I can't recover. I can never recover. I'll never recover. Okay. Put some little vegetables in here. Handle. Might be a little bit too long of a handle. Let me. There we go. As if it never happened. Now, for whatever is under this, you know, let me look up cabin stove. Cabin stove. Stove. Oh, I'm so good at it. So good at typing. Okay, let's see. Okay, these are not the type of stoves I thought a cabin would have. What said stove? I didn't say burner, I guess. Well, I guess. Okay, no, there are burners. Technically, at the top. Okay, yeah. You know, I can make this work. I can do this. Yeah.
notice that.
Okay, now let's see if I can do this. Okay. Let's see if I can do this on the right layer, how about? Okay, so it's gonna be like right here. Fucking hell, I just wanna draw one more squiggly there. There we go. There, okay. Okay, I don't think the burner would be that close, but we can say that he like moved it a bit closer so he could serve a bit better. God. Circle is my weakness. Damn it. Come on. I can do it. I know I can. Please. I just want to draw a circle for the burner. There we go. That's doable. Every time I do stuff like say stuff like that, I remember I think of this like one comic I've seen where like an artist is trying to draw a foot and they're like their mind goes, "What the fuck is that?" Like so aggressively at them, and then they try again. And the braid is like really peering in, and it goes imperfect but sufficient. Like, that's me when I draw. What the fuck is that? Imperfect but sufficient. I need to find it. Such a core memory. There. God. Whatever. I'm putting too much work into this. It's just a sketch, I say. It'll be quick, I say. As I'm drawing this line over and over again. Okay, there. I'm going to draw a step stool. Okay, so I'm going for a little elevated pumpkin-shaped hut. Ooh, okay. That sounds good. So it's kind of like going off of the Aradar houses, pretty much. I think I need like this. Yes. Now I'm just thinking on how to draw stairs for it. Stairs are, you know what, that's me at this step store. Now how do I draw the stairs? There we go, that's how. A mix of everything, to be honest. That's cool, that's nice. Well, you could do like the usual, like basic X stairs, like that, or you could make them like just like steps, sort of. So depending on like what you have for your foundation, you could just do like a step here, and then a step here, just kind of like scattered around. So you don't want to just plop some normal stairs and call it a day. I want to make it fit the theme. Yeah, I can send you a screenshot of what I got. Yeah, sure. I'm waiting ever so patiently. I have Discord open. fix this while I'm at it. There we go. That was bothering me for some reason. Erase all this. And then, yeah. Okay, there we go. Okay, let me see. Sent. I watched it happen. Oh, okay. I see how you have it. So yeah, that's very elevated. It's not like it's on like a amount of dirt. Okay, I see. That is interesting. Yeah, because I see how you like you don't want to put like normal stairs. You could do like. I was about to say, you could do maybe, like, a rope ladder. Because, like, the way you have drawn this one, maybe. But then again, Twig has such small arms. Would he be able to climb it? But, I don't know. Let me see. Tree house stairs. Let me see if... No, that's boring. That's just, like, regular stairs, though. I mean, you could... I might do the small scattered step idea. Yeah. If that works out. I wasn't sure if that would really work out with, like, the way you have it drawn here. But if you think of something, if you think that's right, you know. You could form the vines in a way that makes stairs. That just kind of, like, layered on top of each other. But, like, and they're, like, scattered at the same time, too. So it's kind of like... Let's see, this is the house. And here is the vine. So it's kind of like one here, one here, one here, depending. Something like that. With my shitting drawing. Oh, you could do it with leaves. You could do that too, yeah. I didn't go with leaves at first because it was like, but how heavy are the pumpkin buds here? Yeah, that is a thought, too. You'll just have to try them all out. Also, aren't you streaming in, like, a minute, by the way? Some Kingdom Hearts. Ha ha. Ha ha. Why the ha ha ha? Ha 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 ha. Yes, okay. I was like, what's that supposed to mean? What do you know that I don't? But I see now. Okay. I have nothing open. Jack! You gotta stop doing that. I have nothing open. Oopsie daisies. Listen, Art. I mean, you right. Alright, I wanna... This is bothering me. This is up way too high. But you are right. I thought you said ha and you'd be like, I'm not streaming, I'm just doing art. I changed my mind. But the Kingdom Hearts. Well, I understand indeed. Alright, let's put this here, there. Now I feel better. I feel better, so much better about what I've got going on here. Thank you for the lurk, Jack. Good luck. For those of you that don't know, Jack is about to stream at some Kingdom Hearts 2 with their girlfriend, Mel. If Mel is joining. Sometimes Mel's a little late to the party. But she's usually there. So yeah, guess what Jack's made? Did I mention it was Kingdom Hearts 2? I wasn't sure if I just said Kingdom Hearts or not, but yeah. So if you guys like Kingdom Hearts, you should go check Jack out. do it, or else I'll beat you up. With kindness. Smile. But yeah. Alright, I think that's pretty good. It's a lot more... I was kind of worried it wasn't going to be as like a scene as much as I wanted it to be. But you know what? I got it going. I have it. I am the moment. I did it. Ooh, this one, you know, I'm just going to erase this part because I was using a cabin stairs of a restaurant. They kind of go like this along the edge, but I don't know how I can get that on here. But you know what? It's fine. It's fine. All right. Should I color? Should I truly color? I feel like I have to color. It is written. Okay, let me put a little bit of... like a heart. Because he loves cooking chef bread. Ah, sorry. Didn't mean to smack that. This also was giving me ideas for more of like the interior of the cabin as well. Like with like the stove and all that. Because I wasn't really thinking about it until just now. I was like, a little thing, oh, I gotta think about the kitchen a little bit. Damn it. Shaggy got first in Jack's chat. I hate that. I hate that. I wanted it. Sorry. Oh well. Alright, we'll finish up with this little drawing here. And then that will be it for me today. Like I said, it's a little shorter stream today because I kind of went hard yesterday. Just a little bit. With the Our Life stream. So yeah, a bit shorter than usual, but short streams are good too. Oops. The line art layer. I'm gonna have to be careful over here though. Okay, I need to figure out how to wanna do the coloring here. Oops. Yo, give me my gouache can work. I kinda like the texture it gives. Listen, I dream of being able to do like a full like kitchen scene, draw all the details and everything like that, but not today guys. I can't do that. My brain is not branding right now. I'm not ready for that commitment. There we go. Okay.
One giant leap for mankind.
Pulling it down a little bit. There we go. All right. Nice. Now I can go in and clean up. Maybe finally figure out Chef Bread's colors, though. Because this is going to be a little difficult if I can't figure it out. Chef Bread doesn't make bread, he makes soup. What can you do? He's just a cool little dude. Do I want to use the bread coloring? I don't know. Give me this one. Maybe I'll mess with the lighting a bit and see how I feel about that. Okay, bring this down. There we go. Just some like simple lighting and rendering, nothing too crazy. It'll still take me 8 years to do, but still. No, this one. Pardon me. nice so far. Alright, now the... I'm sorry I keep, like, going up here. I'm trying to, like, click on the window. Where he's at, but I keep missing. Okay. Potato soup, kind of around, like, this color? I want to be a little bit more brighter than that. There we go. Even if it doesn't give potato soup, it can still give some sort of soup vibe, you know? You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm putting down? And then we'll do some little... Yeah, it's giving more stew vibes now, but you know what? It's okay. Something delicious, at least. Maybe a little bit of green in there. He's a chef. I don't know what he puts in there. I just eat it and it tastes good, you know? Maybe some, like, darker chunks of a vegetable. Maybe, like, potato skin. Yeah, okay. Next, we should color the silver. BB's earrings are too light for my liking. Let's make it a nice... What's this? Put more blue tone in it. Yeah, something around there. Yeah, there we go. Okay. That's what I was thinking of. I should go put it down on the lower layer. What I've already done, pretty much. Go. Shit. Change. That's too big. What the fuck? Okay, there we go. What happened? Alright. Take this, and I'm gonna just make like a one highlight color, pretty much. There we go. Maybe use the brush. The round mixing brush. Highlight. Spice it up a little bit. Oh, I need to take this color later before I forget to make it easier on myself. Miss it to professional later. Alright. There we go. Now let's color that bowl. I'm just gonna make this like a wooden bowl, pretty much. So I'm gonna make it look a nice little tan color. A darker one to go against the... the soup, I should say. There we go. Sorry. I was trying to make sure this wasn't, like, too similar to the fur color. Actually, maybe I should make it red, because, you know what? Give me that. I'm gonna make it brighter. Yeah, okay. That's better. Add some more color instead of just all that. Okay, and then we just have the stairs and the stove left. Mm-hmm. hearts as well. Okay, now for the stone, I'm just gonna go very dark. Throw that in there. Wait, actually. Let me see if I can just grab that. No, I'm on the wrong layer. Grab that. There we go. Blue toned. There we go. Alright. Oh, we got that mess there. There we go. Alright, nice. Now last is the stairs, which I will make a lighter brown. For reals this time, I swear. Yeah, there we go. Perfect. Beautiful. Yeah, ship bread. Be happy. Happy, happy, happy. With his little soup that he made with love. Okay, now let's take everything apparently. I meant. Stop! Okay, put that down. Okay, take his color. Oh shit, it's too similar to that. Damn it. Now how do I... Okay, grab this. Let's try this again. This is why it's important to make sure you know what you're doing with your colors. Oh, that's way too far. I've gone too far. There we go. There we go. Very splotchy, but that's okay. There we go, I fix. Alright, now... I take the color. I get on the right layer, and I take the color. There we go. I'm very happy. I swear. Okay, so let's make this bread color. Okay, so maybe... What if I just change... Oh, he's green now. I don't know, I'm so torn because I want him... I want to try color variations, but then when I try, I'm like, no, it's too different. I don't want to. So I don't know. Maybe just like a little lighter. And then a little bit more saturated. I mean, that's not bad. Let's see, 8, 9, okay. Oh, shit. Oh, Arr. It's too similar. Okay, let me try this. Maybe a little bit over here. Oh! I just turned off my tablet. Well, it's good to know that if I turn my tablet off, you guys can still see it. Even if I can't. Alright, there we go. I'm just so torn. You know what? I'll keep it default for now. This is still concept. This isn't canon yet. That's my excuse that I'm sticking with it. Alright, let me get... some warm lighting in here. Let's it's like just practically radiating. Go up. What if I put this in a folder? And then... maybe a soft light would be better. Ooh. Oh, I was trying to make this bigger. It's as big as it can get. Need a hard light? Ew. Vivid light. Linear. Pin. Hard. Exclusion. Overlay. Add glow. Add. Now. No, this is good enough. Okay, and then phew, multiply. Just a little bit, not too much. I don't want this whole... she is struggling. I'm sorry, I'm just trying to make this look good, like a sketch. Something like that.
It's like the sun shining through on a beautiful day.
I'm gonna use red instead of whatever the fuck I was just using. There we go. Take the soft brush and phew. Maybe I should actually set this to multiply. Yeah, there we go. Okay. Multiply again. Psh. Yeah. So when we zoom in and we look.
No, I think it's good enough. I think we're doing pretty good. Yeah, I like them. Very cute, and then we write.
Give me your line art color. Give me my calligraphy pen. I want to draw this cool. Shift.
Red. That is him. That is the bear we done today.
And there we have it. Chef Bread. I didn't really intend for this to just be focused on one bear, but I'm not mad about it. I'm glad that he's like started coming into his own character throughout the stream, pretty much. He's already become a super beloved. I still need to figure out colors, but you know what? The character himself, very nice. Very big. Very precious.
We love to see it. BB, this is your big friend, big and thick.
So I will probably be continuing to develop him off stream. We'll probably, if we do continue the bear bud concepts next week, it will be a different bear bud. I'm gonna try to do a little bit different here. But yeah, so that's gonna be it from me. That is it. I hope you guys enjoy. I mean, we got a good bit done. We got a nice little sketch here of BB and Tabby. And then we have our little concepts here of Chef Bread, which I think we're nicely done. You can't see all of them because my fucking camera on this sucks. And then our final image to end off on, which I think is a very nice one. Shows off his character very nicely. A big bear, a big tummy, and a big heart who cooks with a lot of love. But yeah, I'm pretty pleased with myself, so I'll be posting this in the Discord later on. This image here, I'll probably leave the concepts out of it. Yeah, oh, and speaking of, if you'd like to join the Discord, here's the Discord, and also here's the Twitter as well. If you follow either, join either, you will be notified to when I go live here on Twitch. You'll gain access to the stream schedule, so you'll know what I'll be streaming, what, when, and where, what time, you know. Tomorrow, you'll see that tomorrow we're actually playing Pokemon. I almost said Kingdom Hearts because looking at Jack. I'm going to be playing Pokemon with Jack later on, so you'll be able to see stuff like that on there. And also on the Discord, you'll gain access to polls that affect future streams. For example, I like to make Thursdays. I'm trying to make Thursdays now, from now on, to be a day that you guys get to pick from a list of choices and what we play. So, for example, last week, we had the options of two Subnautica streams. So I always stream Subnautica in Our Life Beginnings and Always each week. So the two those two options are always there to have two sessions for the week. So it's just like, you know, we have our Subnautica stream and then we have another one on Thursday. And then we also have like three other options that rotate each week. So it's never really the same a batch. And this time around, it was Animal Crossing, Overwatch 2, and Dogs Organized Neatly. Everybody, okay, well, it doesn't show it now, but it was a four-way tie last time, but everybody's trying to cover up their tracks, and, like, they voted when it was already done. So I had to use the wheel to decide, and Overwatch 2 was picked. So that's what we will be playing. So if you guys are interested in voting in the future, feel free to join, you know? I can't guarantee what will be on this week's. I do have some ideas, but you'll just have to look, you know? You'll just have to join. Yeah, okay, so let me, oh my god, no, there, okay, I'm done, I swear. No, I'm never done. I just like things to look good, you know. There we go, that's better. All right. So that shall be it from me for today. Let me go ahead and put all my stuff away before I forget. Okay, my chopsticks, my rice, my tablet, because I'm not drawing anymore. And I'll zoom on over here. So thank you guys very much for joining me today. I hope y'all had fun. I certainly did. I had a great time. I always love drawing these buds. I had so much fun last time. That's why I did it again this week. And maybe we'll do 3 for 3. You never know. Maybe we'll focus on Tabby next time, BB's little sister, or maybe we'll focus on somebody else. Well, who knows? Only the future does. But yeah, so let's see here. Let me see. Who can I throw you guys at? Oh, I guess I'll throw you at Jack then. I usually like to make a point to kind of raid people that are doing something similar to me. But no one's doing all right now, so you know, we'll just go hang out with Jack. Like I said, Jack is playing Kingdom Hearts 2. I love Kingdom Hearts. So we'll go hang out with Jack. And they are joined by Mel, the power duo. So yeah, I hope you guys have a good time with Jack. I know Jack will take good care of you. Jack always, streams are always super fun. Oh, save. Oh shit, I accidentally closed the file. Oh, I need to open that up. I'm gonna post later. But yeah. So I hope to see you guys tomorrow for Jack and I's collab stream. We always have a collab each week on Wednesdays because we're playing Pokemon Scarlet and Violet together. It's my first time playing It's Jack's second time, but it's their first time playing on Scarlet. So we've been playing it together. We're kind of speedrunning right now because Jack will remind me tomorrow, but there's an event going on in like September, so we have to finish before then. So we're going to be speedrunning a little bit, but you know what? That's okay. That makes it fun. So I hope if you guys are interested, I hope to see you then. And if not, I hope you all have a good time wherever you are. So that's, like I said, that's it for me today. Thank you all so much for joining as per usual. I hope you guys have a good rest of your day. And I hope to see you guys in the next one. Stay feral. All right, goodbye. Bye, bye, bye.